Let's go to Jim Ross right now. Jim, how do you think these two matches are going to turn out?
Well, interestingly enough, all four men, gentlemen, have never competed in the King of the Ring before. You've got Wild Man Mark Merrow and Stone Cold Steve Austin, two highly regarded newcomers looking to win their first title in the World Wrestling Federation. On the other hand, you've got the overwhelming favorite, the 450-pound Vader, the biggest man in the King of the Ring, a man that's had a lot of time to prepare for his opponent, Jake the Snake Roberts, who's got to be the overwhelming underdog in tonight's sold-out event in the Mecca Arena. Well, as we continue our conversation with Jake Roberts, I asked Jake down in Stone Mountain, Georgia, why, at this stage of his career, would he even want to enter competition as grueling as the King of the Ring?
I've been there, done that, got the T-shirt, seen the movie. I've done it all. You know, so I could be happy with what I've been through as far as career-wise. I mean, I've been to the top of the mountain, stayed there for 15 years. Not many people ever been to the top. Not many people at all have ever stayed that long. I can think of two or three people. To be involved in King of the Ring tournament is an opportunity for me to show the world that Jake Roberts is competitive. Jake Roberts is still worthy of the opportunities. Jake Roberts is still fun to watch. Jake Roberts is still a dangerous man when he steps into that squared circle. Milwaukee, it's going to be tough.
Tough? Well, that's an understatement for the 41-year-old Jake the Snake Roberts, who knew that should he survive in the early rounds of the King of the Ring, that in the semifinals tonight in Milwaukee, his first opponent would be Vader.
To win it, twice in one night. First man, Vader. 450, not somebody you play with. Not somebody you can step on and expect not to get up. Your man's going to come back up. But you know, I've always said if I was going to rob a bank that I wouldn't walk in the front door. I'd walk in the back door, sneak up behind somebody, hit him with a stick. If that's what it takes to get by Vader, don't worry. Jake Roberts is still ready for that type of test. Jake Roberts still knows how to deal with that type of situation. Just because I became a Christian doesn't mean that I won't go out there and mix it up with you. Cause that's what it's all about.
No one knows that any better than Jake the Snake Roberts, but folks, I had to ask why Jake thought that he actually had a chance in becoming the King of the Ring.
Jake Roberts is going to be where he needs to be. Jake Roberts isn't as fast as he used to be. Jake Roberts is heavier than he used to be. But Jake Roberts was never a bodybuilder. Jake Roberts was a technician. Jake Roberts was a chess player. Jake Roberts played with your mind. Jake Roberts carried a large snake that you better think about. Jake Roberts has the most devastating hold in professional wrestling today, yesterday, forever. Sorry, Brett. The DDT. I've never tried to overpower anybody. I never tried to dance. Jake Roberts went out and did Jake Roberts. The snake doesn't drop kick people. The snake doesn't crawl to the top of the rope. Why? Because I don't have to tell you the truth. For those people that say I can't do it anymore, hide and watch. People said I couldn't beat Andre the Giant. I did.
None of us will ever forget the legendary battles between Jake Roberts and the late, great Andre the Giant. But what can we expect tonight in Milwaukee?
Always expect the unexpected from Jake. I mean, you can expect me to give 100%. You can expect me to walk into that ring proud and walk out the same way, win or lose. My comfort comes from a different place now. It doesn't come from adulation from people. It doesn't come from money in my pocket. Expect a fight. Expect Jake Roberts to leave his mark somewhere on somebody, preferably in the finals.
Well, for old Jake to make it to the finals, he has a huge mountain to climb in the shape of the 450-pound Vader. But Jake Roberts, folks, has overcome adversity before, as we have documented right here on the Ross Report. Jake Roberts admitted and has dealt with his problems with drug and alcohol abuse. And we certainly want to wish the 41-year-old veteran the very best of luck tonight in Milwaukee in what probably will be his last opportunity to compete for a WWF title. It certainly would surprise many if Jake Roberts were to become the King of the Ring, but I really believe that tonight's pay-per-view spectacular will be full of surprises. I just got that feeling that either the British Bulldog, Ahmed Johnson, or the Godwins will walk out of the sold-out Mecca Arena tonight with gold around their waist. And we'll be covering everything for you on the WWF Superstar Line. And the number is 1-900-737-4WWF. It's only $1.49 per minute. And folks, tonight on Option 8, we'll have exclusive post-match interviews with the winners and the losers of every contest from the King of the Ring tonight from Milwaukee, that exclusively on Option 8. And folks, when we come back, we'll be rejoined by Doc and Todd, and they'll take an in-depth look at the Shawn Michaels British Bulldog collision tonight in Milwaukee, and we'll show you Shawn Michaels' latest talk show appearance here on The Zone.